Well, hello, you awesome human beings. How in the heck are you? We're going to start a fire today without any matches or a lighter. We're going to use some cotton that I had left over from when I vaped. Call it cotton bacon, and that's the StrikeForce lighter, ferro rod with a striker there.
The name's Striker. I'm sitting down and facing front.
Why would you want to know that?
And in the back, and you can actually store some your Tinder in the back end of it. I, of course, have lost the cap to close that off, so I have some in a plastic bag. We'll eventually close that up. So that's what you use to start a fire. Let's do this. Yeah. And there's our StrikeForce lighter, or fire starter, not a lighter. And I'm actually here, I'm just trying to get a screenshot, got a thumbnail. That would do it right there. And that's the cotton that I am going to use to start me a fire. And the fire that the tinder that I'm using is a little damp. So it's not, it gave me a fit. I burned a big log in the fire pit, but I was out there for literally five hours just trying to get the fire to take, you know, to catch. And it was just constant feeding the fire. I had nothing else to do on my day off. So you put you some, what is preferably dry, really dry leaves, twigs, and sticks, which they were dry, but just, they were just damp. It killed me. It was a bit of a learning experience. And that's the cotton, and from the ferro rod that I got, the StrikeForce ferro rod, that it should be popping up in the video sometime soon. We're gonna go ahead and scrape some of that onto the cotton. So fire needs fuel, and the cotton needs fuel to burn. It's a lot easier using a fire, you know, matches. It burns up. That cotton just burns up really quick. That's why I say when I'm using for tinder, the leaves and the twigs, that should, if they were really, really dry, that would have went up really quick. But, you know, that's how you can learn by doing. And fire is very important to me, you know, during hurricane season or whatever, when you have no power, or if you're out camping, I like to have a fire. If you want to cook, you gotta have fire. That's why I have a propane grill. I cheat. But that fire is, you see, there's a lot of smoke. A lot of smoke's going to be putting out from that fire. And it was, I wouldn't say difficult. It was just challenging to get that fire going. As in a second here, you're going to see the fire's just not catching. Producing a lot of smoke. And that's not what I like to see when I start a fire. I don't like to see that much smoke. So what you have to do is feed the fire. And how do I do that? Well, I think right now I'm going inside. I'm going to come back out and I grab that, which is, you can fan the flames with anything. That's just an old cookie sheet I use. And just fan the flames a little bit faster than that. And sometimes I cheat and use a fan. And don't get the fan too close to the fire, so you can see kids. It'll burn it up. But, so we're gonna fan the flames manually. And that fire, here in a little bit, it's gonna kick back up, because it needs oxygen, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just giving the fire, there you go. Pops right back up. And you keep working with it. And you'll have a fire. And then when you have a good little fire and you get all the coals burning down on the ground, then you get something like that. And then you start adding your bigger logs. And then when it really gets going, you put a big old log on there and you have a fire for the rest of the day or the rest of the night. Other than that, that's about it, kids. Y'all have a good one. Thanks for watching. Get outside and have some fun. Peace to you. Tighten up.